song, Majestic.
Oh, Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Scripture reading here is John 11, 17 through 27. On his arrival, Jesus found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now, Bethany was less than 2 miles from Jerusalem, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them in the loss of their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went out to meet him, but Mary stayed at home. "Lord," Martha said to Jesus, "if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, God will give you whatever you ask." And Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." And Martha answered, "I know he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." And Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this?"
"Yes, Lord," she replied. "I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, who is to come into the world."
Pretty tough act to follow. Please join me in the scripture reading. Today's scripture reading comes from John 11, 20 through 37. After she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary aside. "The teacher is here," she said, "and is asking for you." When Mary heard this, she got up quickly and went to him. Now Jesus had not yet entered the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews who had been with Mary in the house, comforting her, noticed how quickly she got up and went out, they followed her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn there. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. "Where have you laid him?" he asked. "Come and see, Lord," they replied. Jesus wept. Then the Jews said, "See how he loved him?" But some of them said, "Cannot he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?"
Mm-hmm.
John 11:38-45. Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. "Take away the stone," he said. "But Lord," said Martha, the sister of the dead man, "by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there 4 days." Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, Jesus called out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out!" The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped in strips of linen and cloth across his face. Then Jesus said to them, "Take off his grave clothes and let him go." Therefore, many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what Jesus had done believed in him.
Substance of my soul. I have filled this void with things unreal. And all the while my character it steals. Lord, this is a harsh tomb, don't you think? Grace thing works. It's not the long walk home that will change this heart, but the welcome I receive with the restart. I see. Darkness is gone too far this time. You have neither reason nor rhyme with which to take this soul that is so rightfully mine.
Not bad for a debut, was it? Guys, thank you so much. Been a fun service so far with great music, praise teams playing super music, and that tops it off. This is an evening to think some about the fact that Christ had the ability to roll away the stone and to call Lazarus out. He has that same ability to call us out, to roll away the stones in our lives, those things that keep us kind of buried, and to give us new life. And so we celebrate that. We're gonna have a video that I want you to watch. It's a story about a guy who is in Africa. He's in many ways in the mission field, and he is struggling with his belief. And one of the Africans has been struck by lightning, and they think for all intents and purposes she has died. And so they call him because they know that he prays to God, and God is bigger than they can understand. So I want to invite you to watch this video as we do this. And you might, there you go.
Quentin John. Yes, a manch. Un culo culo. Ai, mamma. Stand up, mamma. Un culo culo. Opa, copil. Lalelani. Amanda con culo culo asa benzala. Do you understand? Un culo culo.
It's the power of God that gives life. It's an amazing little clip there. One that perhaps we can learn from. Because oftentimes I think that I give myself life. I give myself power. I give myself the ability to be the person I am. But there's a reminder that constantly comes to me that it's not me, it's God. And maybe that's what this is about. The Mumford & Sons song, great song, talks about having this this grace given to us and our heart being changed and us seeing something different about ourselves that we never saw before. Why? Because God had the ability to raise Lazarus from the dead, or to raise us from the dead. Y'all heard the saying, I wish these walls could talk, because they've heard so much. And I'm not sure that the walls here could talk that much, but I was watching the news last night, and there was a story about out in Gettysburg, they're redoing a house, a pre-Civil War house. And when they took the walls, the interior walls off, they discovered inside of the walls perfectly just like they were, written letters that were written during the Civil War. There were bottles that were stored in there. Just an amazing story. And I was reminded of a friend of ours up in New York State who owns a home in a place called Sinclairville, which is near Jamestown, New York. And he bought a house from an Amish fella who probably had had this home in his family for years and years and years. There was no electricity there when he bought the house. They had just put in some new windows. And so Jim totally redid this house. And I went and helped him a couple days, and I remember him showing me this incredible board that he found. When he was taking the old wood off of the stairwell, he turned a piece over before he threw it away, and he realized that there was a piece of newspaper that somehow had become stuck to the wood inside of this board. And so he looked at it, and on this piece of wood was the newspaper clipping announcing that Abraham Lincoln had been assassinated. If these walls could speak. When, in a sense, that's what the scriptures do for us. The scriptures are the walls that have the ability to speak to us over and over and over. The scriptures are able to do that. It's the ancient words that the Second Chance folks let us in earlier. Those ancient words that never quit being alive for us have the ability to speak to us. So the ancient words tonight talk to us about Lazarus. Now, what do we know about Lazarus? I guess what we really should think of is, what do we know about Jesus? Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus was both human and divine. And Jesus, as humans, seemed to have friends, some friends that were closer than other friends. When we read the scriptures in John, we discover that there's a disciple who Jesus loved. We don't know who that is. Some folks think that that's John, the son of Zebedee, but others think it could have been someone else. So we know that Jesus had a closer relationship with John. We know he had a closer relationship with some of the other disciples. But here we find that he has a close relationship with a family. And the family is made up of Mary and Martha and Lazarus. And so there's this close-knit family. So word comes that Lazarus is sick. Now, we know that if we read about Jesus, what does he do when someone is sick? He drops what he's doing and he goes and he heals them. Yet in this situation, he doesn't go and heal Lazarus. He waits, he hangs back. He lets his good friend die from this sickness. And so there's a wonderment of, why would he do that? Why would he not go there? And the disciples want to know, why doesn't he go and heal him? But he doesn't. So for 4 days, he lays in a tomb. So Jesus goes there, and eventually Mary and Martha come to him, and they take him to the tomb. And what does Jesus do? But says, Lazarus, come out of the tomb. He raises him from the dead. Now the symbolism of that for us is that it's a kind of a sign. See, in the scriptures, especially in John's gospel, this is the last miracle that Jesus does before his own death. So it's the last miracle. He raises Lazarus from the grave. But in John's gospel, sometimes miracles are also referred to as signs. And so this one is referred to as a sign. It's a sign of what's to come for Jesus. It's a sign that he too will die and be raised from the grave, which means that he'll overcome death. He will put death to death itself. In that death comes the gift of forgiveness of sins and the resurrection of the body. And we celebrate that. But how do we know? How do we know that to be true? In the video clip that we just watched, the folks saw that the man had gone in there and this girl suddenly was alive. And they wanted to quickly give him the credit. And he gives the credit to who? He gives the credit to God. God saved her. God raised her from the dead. And God has the ability to do the same thing for us. God can take us, whoever we are, wherever we are, whatever we're into, the things we've done, the things we've said, the places we've gone that we shouldn't have, and offer us forgiveness and change the heart inside of us and give us this incredible gift of grace. And that's what the Lenten season is about. It's about seizing that gift of grace, knowing that as you repent of your sins, as you ask for forgiveness, that forgiveness is offered to you. And repentance occurs. And forgiveness occurs. And grace occurs. And whatever it is that keeps you inside of a tomb, the stone can be rolled away and you can walk out and be alive. Put your hands up to God and say, "Here I am, Lord. Here I am." So whatever it is for you, just know that God, who is both human and divine through Jesus Christ, cares for you, loves you, and through his Holy Spirit gives you this wonderful gift of life. Celebrate the gift. Celebrate the love. Let's pray. Lord God, as we come to you this evening and continue this process of moving through the Lenten season, we now find ourselves in the fifth week. Next Sunday is Palm Sunday, time for your triumphal entry into Jerusalem. And then Easter, a time where we remember that you too were in the tomb and that the stone was rolled away and you were given life again. The only way we have to believe that is through faith. Because we can't see it, but we know it to be true. So may our faith be strong as we seek to be followers of you, as the Lord and the Savior of all. In your Son's name we pray. Amen. I invite you to stand for the statement of faith.
Please join me. This is the good news which we have received, in which we stand, and by which we are saved, if we hold fast that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day, and that he was first to the women, then to Peter, and to the 12, and then to many faithful witnesses. We believe that Jesus is Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus Christ is the first and the last, and the beginning and the end. He is our Lord and our God. Amen.
There is love.
Let's give all our musicians a hand for tonight. Excellent job. Y'all can sing anytime here in this chapel. As you go forth tonight, know that you go forth as people who have received the gift of grace, grace that has the ability to take and change you and to give you that sense of love that perhaps you're lacking or searching for in life. Know that the Lord blesses you with that, that the Lord's face shines upon you wherever you go and whatever you're into. And as you do that, know that you're never alone. So go forth in peace. Rejoice in the power of God's Holy Spirit for each of you, both now and forevermore. And together we say, amen. I'd like to invite you to be seated as the folks send us out with a good song.